Hey guys, welcome back to the Wozanazo Transfer Show. On today's episode, we have Gordinho and Kotei leave Amakosi, Akumu to Chiefs, and Keagan Dolly could be reuniting with Castro and Billiat. We kick off the show with Lorenzo Gordinho and James Kotei officially parting ways with Kaizer Chiefs. Amakosi have decided to release two fringe players, with Kaizer Chiefs announcing the departures of Lorenzo Gordinho and James Kotei. The two players were expected to leave the Naturena Bay side during the current transfer window, after struggling for game time this season. Chiefs have confirmed that the former South African youth international Lorenzo Gordinho will join Bidvest Wits, with Ghanaian midfielder James Kotei's contract being terminated by the club. The defender will join Bidvest Wits on a 2.5-year deal, while Ghanaian midfielder James Kotei's contract has been terminated by a mutual agreement. Kotei joined the Glamour Boys from Tanzanian champions Simba FC before the current season. The midfielder has reflected on his short spell with Amakosi, speaking to the club's official website. "I would like to thank the club's chairman Kaizer Mutawung for the warm reception he gave me. Also Bobby Mutawung for the love and care he showed me," said Kotei. "Even though I wasn't successful at Kaizer Chiefs, I love the unity and love there, and I admire the professionalism of the club. I really hope Kaizer Chiefs can become champions this season." Kotei has been linked with Tanzanian giants, Young Africans, and Zambian champions, Zesco United, while Kenyan midfielder Anthony Akumu is set to replace him at Kaizer Chiefs, with Goal receiving exclusive information that the Kenyan international has signed a deal with Amakosi already. Teddy Akumu is primed to sign a 3-year deal with Kaizer Chiefs, which could keep him at the club until 2023, said a close source to the deal. On the other hand, Gordinho was said to have an emotional goodbye to the club where he started his career before being promoted from the club's academy. "I want to thank everyone at Kaizer Chiefs, the chairman, the Mutawung family, and all the coaches and staff, everyone that played a role in my growth as a player and as a person. I will never forget the friendship I developed with the people at the club at various levels. I will take it all, what I've learned at Chiefs, into my next chapter of my playing career." Kaizer Chiefs footballing manager Bobby Mutawung admitted that the lack of game time played a role in both players' exit. He said the split with Kotei was amicable, as the player who last featured in a preseason friendly was not playing. Gordinho, on the other hand, is a Kaizer Chiefs youth product who has had a long decade involved in the club and would like to see him see his future at greener pastures. "Lorenzo leaving us is a touchy one, especially he's almost been here for 10 years, starting in our development. His challenges, however, was getting game time," said Mutawung. "We also didn't want to block his career as he got the opportunity to join another top club. We thank you, Lorenzo, for your service to Kaizer Chiefs all those years." The duo becomes the second and third player to leave Kaizer Chiefs in the general transfer window. Midfielder Kabelo Matlasela was the first, after joining Polokwane City on a loan earlier this month. Coach Ernst Mittendorp has revealed that there has been talks behind closed doors regarding the immediate futures of some of the club's fringe players, with a few players growing frustrated on the sidelines. Mittendorp said the door is open for any player who has identified a move elsewhere and could guarantee him more minutes on the field. "We will always respect each and everybody. If there's a situation that a player wants to change in order to get game time and he sees he can get it at another PSL team, the door is open." Another player who could have a cards on the move is midfielder Sphilile Ntshangase, who has played no parts in Kaizer Chiefs' ongoing campaign. The former Baroka star has been linked with a move back to Limpopo and could see him link up with his former team Black Leopards for the remainder of the season. "I believe Amakosi are in the process of cleaning out all the dead wood within the club as they try to pursue the APSA Premiership title." Moving on to one of the biggest stories currently making the rounds in the PSL transfer rumor mill. Keagan Dolly could be joining Kaizer Chiefs from Montpellier. Reports suggesting that Kaizer Chiefs are interested in signing former Mamelodi Sundowns winger Keagan Dolly, with injuries hampering his progress in Europe. Reports have surfaced that he's wanted by the PSL Ligue leaders. The speculation raised hopes for the Glamour Boys as they were looking to see the nippy midfielder reunite with Leonardo, Castro and Khama, Billiat, also known as CBD, at Sundown. However, Amakosi have denied the links as pure speculation, with Chiefs communication manager addressing the links with the club signing the Bafana midfielder Keagan Dolly. The former Mamelodi Sundowns player could make a return to South African football, but the comments of the Chiefs communication manager begs to differ. From a Chiefs point of view, we are in the window of signing players. This period is where there's so much speculation. Chiefs is a big footballing brand and we are associated with big names. Keagan Dolly is a big name, and to see him linked with Chiefs doesn't surprise us. Our policy has been to remain clear. If we sign a player and the deal is done, we will not miss an inch or time or even an opportunity to inform our supporters. With Keagan Dolly's agent commenting on the move as well, stating his client is firmly interested in furthering his career in Europe and fighting for his place in Montpellier. I don't know where this comes from. Dolly still wants to play in Europe. Keagan is focused on his recovery and getting back onto the field to play for Montpellier. After delivering a stellar display for the Brazilians and winning the CAF Champions League in 2016 and the PSL title, as well as a Telecom Cup title, the 26-year-old caught the attention of French Ligue 2 outfit and joined them in 2017. However, injuries have hampered his progress in Europe, and Amakosi could see this is an opportunity to get their man. Could Keagan Dolly be joining Amakosi in January? All we can do is speculate until further news develops. Anthony Akumu could be announced in the upcoming days as the latest Amakosi signing, and more exits are expected from Amakosi in the upcoming days. Yep guys, this is all I have for you in this video. Please leave your comments and what you think about the transfers and what you think is going on in the January transfer window, players you'd like to see at Amakosi, what you think is going to happen in Kaizer Chiefs in the next few days, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.